We will kick off today's highlights at yesterday's swimming finals at the Taiwan Sport University Arena in New Taipei City. It was the men's 800-meter freestyle final that was up first. You're going to want to keep an eye on lane six. That's Italy's Gregoria Paltarini. He won the gold in the 800-meter freestyle earlier in the competition and competed at the 2012 Olympics when he was just 17 years old. He also won the gold medal at the 2016 Olympic Games in the 1500-meter freestyle. Earlier this year, he won the gold at the World Championship and the bronze in the 800-meter. He leads the way after the first length. Paltarini way ahead of the Universiad record. He touches the wall, and with a time of 7 minutes, 45.76 seconds, he crushes the Universiad record that was previously 7 minutes and 47.24 seconds. He takes the gold, and it's two athletes from the Ukraine that are up on the podium with him. Next up is the women's 200-meter breaststroke final. It was Japan's Kanako Watanabe who was the favorite in this event after winning the gold in the 100-meter breaststroke earlier in the competition. At 15 years old, she participated at the 2012 Olympics, also competed just this past summer in the 2016 Olympics. Now, she wasn't one of the leaders after the first length, but the turn would push her ahead as she would push forward and end with a time of 2 minutes 24.15 seconds. In lane four, it's this last couple meters. She pushes ahead and kicks it into high gear. She takes the gold, and it's an athlete from South Africa who takes the silver, and Russia earns the bronze. Now it's time for the men's 100-meter freestyle final. Eight athletes from the United States of America, Poland, Japan, Brazil, Russia, and the Ukraine took to the water, and this was a quick one. Early on in the race, it was the Ukraine's Serhiy Shevtov that took the early lead, but he would end up finishing in last place in this final event. In second place after the first touch is Brazil's Spajari Silva, and the USA's Ryan Held was in third. But Held in lane four would kick it into another gear nearing the end. At the end of it, he does take the gold with a time of 48.36 seconds. You can see no records will be broken here. Keep an eye on lane four as he approaches the wall. He touches first and wins the gold medal. Poland comes in second, and it's the Japanese athlete that wins the bronze. For American Olympian Ryan Held, this is his second gold medal at the Universiad after also winning the gold in the men's 4x100-meter freestyle relay event back on August 20th. And he wins this individual event by 0.02 seconds. Next up is the women's 100-meter butterfly final. A bit of an underdog story here for USA's Helen Moffitt, who placed sixth in the 500-meter butterfly event. She started off strong and would come back to win the gold medal in the 100-meter event. At the first touch, she is in second place behind Italy's Elena DeLito. DeLito lets up just a tiny bit in this last 50 meters, allowing Moffitt to race ahead, winning this one by just 0.06 seconds in the final. This one came down to the wire. In lane four is DeLito from Italy. Looks like she is in the lead, but at the very last second, it's USA's Moffitt that pulls ahead by just 0.06 seconds. Helen Moffitt takes the gold, Elena DeLito the silver for Italy, and it's Rochelle Kelly for Great Britain. These three athletes in lane three, four, and five just milliseconds away from each other in the end, Helen Moffitt eventually coming out on top. She will also compete in the 4x100-meter medley relay event tomorrow. Now over to Taipei Stadium for six different athletics finals. After another rain delay here in Taipei City, it was the men's hammer final that saw its first action. Poland's Paweł Fajdzek was a heavy favorite heading into this final. The two-time Olympian won the gold medal at these events in 2011, 2013, and 2015. So looking to defend his title here today. First up is Moldova's Sergei Markhiev. In his second throw, it reaches 74.98. Watch his release here. Gets it up and over. He knows that one is good, and that will be his best here today. Good enough for the bronze medal. Next up is Belarus's Pavel Barysha. He came second at this event at the 2015 Gwangju Universiad, and since then competed at the 2016 Olympics. On his fifth throw, he reached 77.98. Watch just the speed he gets on this throw. Releases at the exact right point, and 77.98 is going to be good enough for the silver medal. And that's because it was the three-time defending champion here at the Universiad, Poland's Paweł Fajdzek. Fajdzek gets some serious speed in the circle there, releases and absolutely dominates this event on his third throw. 79.16. Watch how he uses his shoulders right at the edge of the circle, releases, and that is as good as it gets today. He is now a four-time gold medalist at this event. He adds that title to his three-time world champion resume. Now onto women's long jump. It's Germany's Anna Bueller who kicks it off. We'll watch her second jump here. She reaches 6.28. Now she would do a whole lot better leading up to the end of her event, and her sixth and final jump reaches 6.38, and that would be good enough for the bronze medal. Next up is the athlete from Cyprus, Nektaria Panay. In her very first jump here in the finals, she reaches 6.42, an unbelievable first jump, and it earns her the silver medal. And now the gold medal jump, Romania's Alina Rotaru, takes off and gets 6.65, a huge jump for this Romanian athlete. The smile on her face says it all. She looks up at her coach. Never good enough for the coach, but it is good enough for the gold medal. Look how close her toe got to that line. She used every centimeter possible to get up to the 6.65 that would win her the gold medal. Next, the women's discus final got underway despite the rainy conditions. Up first was Australia's Taryn Golshewski. Golshewski threw in her very last throw 58.11. That would earn her the bronze medal in this event. It was time for the USA's Valerie Allman to take to the circle. After a beautiful toss, uses all the might in her body, reaches 58.36. She would earn the silver medal. Love watching these in slow motion. Watch the release. She watches it go, and it's good enough to get the second place spot. That's because Kristin Pudenz of Germany, she threw a total of 59.09 in her very first throw, and she would earn the gold medal in this event. Now it was time for the women to take to the 100-meter sprints. Eight athletes from Jamaica, Italy, Kazakhstan, Great Britain, Italy, and Switzerland would compete in this final. Shasha Lee Forbes, the American Olympian who just won a silver medal in the 4x100 relay back in 2016, was a heavy favorite in this race. In lane five, she pulls ahead and takes the gold medal with a time of 11.18 seconds. Behind her is Italy's former artistic roller skater, Irene Saragusa, with a personal best of 11.31. You can see just how far ahead the Jamaican athlete here is when she crosses that finish line. And this will be her first gold medal at a summer Universiad. Then it was time for the men's 100-meter final. It was the hometown athlete, Yang Chun Hun, who the crowd was filling in for after the quarterfinals. Word got out that he was in this final race, and it filled the place up. Yang Chun Hun holds the national records in both 100 and 200 meters. He competed at the 2015 Summer Universiad, but his top placement was 15th in the 200-meter race. Look as he pulls ahead here, puts his head, and the crowd goes absolutely crazy. The hometown winner, Yang Chun Hun, wins the first 100-meter gold medal for this home country here at the 2017 Summer Universiad. It came down to a hair as these athletes crossed the finish line. You can see there, he finishes with a time of 10.22. And it's the second place athlete beside him in lane four that ends with a time of 10.24. The third athlete only 0.03 seconds behind them. Finally, it was time for the men's 10,000 meter run, where history would be made for Uganda's Sadiq Bati. Sri Lanka's Muddy Nawasingh took the early lead. You can see him in the red bib and black shorts. He was followed closely by a few athletes, but as the two packs met, it would be up for grabs who would take this lead. You can see him still in the front there representing Sri Lanka, followed closely behind, though, by Uganda's John Katerega. You can see on the right side of your screen there in the yellow jersey, that's Bahati on the outside making his way to the front of the pack, and it's Japan's Kazuya Shiojiri in second. Just over 10 minutes into the race with 16 laps to go, Bahati leads by a large margin. Katerega of Uganda in second, and Japan's Shiojiri trails in third. Now approaching the finish line, Bahati is all alone. He finishes with a time of 29 minutes, 8.68 seconds. Second place goes to Romanian Olympian Nicolae Sor. And not only did Bahati run a personal best here today at the Universiad, he also won the first medal for Uganda here at the 29th Summer Universiad in Taipei. We'll go inside now to the Taiwan University Sports Center, where Brazil took on France in the men's volleyball preliminary round. Earlier in the tournament, it was France who beat Team USA 3-0. They also beat the hometown team of Taipei 3-1. Brazil, on the other hand, beat Japan 3-2, but they lost to Taipei 3-0. So this would be a matchup for the books. To kick it off, it was Brazil on the offensive, but Mario Goncalves spikes it out of bounds and puts France on the board 1-0. Later on, France maintains that lead, and a spike from Jordan Cortegiani builds that lead up. Brazil battles back, though, and with the opportunity to tie, a massive hit by number five, Nicolas Borel, brings the possession back to France. Let's watch that one again. He's able to elevate so high, slammed it right down just past the attack line. Look at that, just beautiful. Now, at set point, an under-the-net penalty by Brazil ends the game, and France now leads 1-0 over Brazil. France would then go on to win the second game as well, but in the third, Brazil battled back in huge comeback fashion. Tied at 23 apiece, a hit by captain Yatin Luti looked to end Brazil's dreams, but at set point, it was another violation that was called, this time in favor of Brazil. Now it's 2-1 for matches France over Brazil. in the fourth. Brazil begins with an early lead, and a hit by Lilson Dos Santos proves that this team means business. Look at this. Right down, no one was able to stop that one. France wasn't going to be walked all over, though, and they answered with a huge spike of their own. Axel Trouchev brings them back to double digits now. It's 15-10, Brazil leading the way over France. Brazil builds on that lead, and at the set point, it's Francis Trouchev that fakes out the D and brings them to 18. We'll watch that one again. He's had a couple monster slams so far in this game, so when he goes up and cocks that arm back, everyone expects a huge hit. He just kind of taps it right over, and no one is there to cover for Brazil. But now Brazil's big man, Neto, takes things into his own hands. He ends the game with a short spike down the line, and he ties it up 2-2. This game would go to a fifth match. Now in the fifth, Brazil in the lead, but France ties it back up 10-10 apiece. Then at set point 26-25, it's Brazil's defense that takes over. France tries to go on the offensive with a spike, but a huge block by right side Brazil's Lilson Dos Santos. He is the hero of the game. That is France's first loss of the tournament. It also brings Brazil to 2-1 in the preliminary round. They will go on to play Team USA tonight. The men's 105-kilogram weightlifting event took place today at the Tamgang University Memorial Gym. 17 athletes qualified for the final, but right now we are going to watch Iran's Kia Ghadami. He competed twice at the World Championship, not taking home a medal in either of those competitions, but this Universiad for him, that would change. His snatch total was 170 kilos, and his first attempt at clean and jerk was 203. Way too easy for him, so his second here, he's lifting 211 kilograms. He's able to push his body to the limits, gets it up over his head, and for a total of 381, he earns the third spot. With this clean and jerk, this is the Armenian's first medal at this year's Summer Universiad. Next up was Russia's Rodion Bochkov. In the snatch, Bochkov lifted 180 kilos, putting him in the number one position, tied for first place. And in his first clean and jerk, he successfully lifted 200 kilos. That put him in the first place round as well. Put it up to 210 for this second lift, and he was able to do it. He ended with a total of 390 kilos. That put him in the number one position, heading into the final lift. And that's because Armenia's Simon Martirosyan, he came up next. His snatch total was the same as the Russians at 180, but his clean and jerk, he would successfully get off 221. When the buzzer goes off, he knows he has it. Martirosyan, with a total of 401, wins the gold medal in the men's 105-kilogram event. Just watch his technique. Absolutely flawless. Armenia's Martirosyan wins the gold. It's Russia's Bochkov with the silver, and Iran's Ghadami who wins the bronze. Martirosyan, who competed and won the silver medal at the 2016 Olympic Games, won Armenia's fourth medal here at the Universiad. He is joined by another weightlifter, a gymnast, and a taekwondo for Armenia. Two more categories for weightlifting will end today with the men's over 105 and the women's over 90 kilogram events. The women's quarterfinals kicked off today at the Fuzhen University Stadium in New Taipei City. This matchup would feature Team USA taking on Team South Africa. Both teams making their way onto the pitch now after both qualifying for this playoff round. It was the victory over Argentina for Team USA that got them here, and for South Africa, a victory over Russia would bring them to today's game. South Africa had the first shot on net, and with the rebound, she tries to put it in again, but just a bit too far to the left. USA would battle back though with an answer. Riley Baisden, too far this time to the right. Nobody would be able to put a point on the scoreboard in the first 28 minutes of this game. The USA would get a good chance on net here, the header just far to the other side of the net this time. No good for Team USA. And then for South Africa, they would have a great shot on net as well. Captain Rafaelo Jane kicks it in right in front of the crease, but unfortunately for them, right into the hands of USA goalkeeper Hannah Siebert. Another header for USA. Aaliyah Miller, she gets that one off the top of her dome, but hurts her a little bit. She would go on, though, unharmed to play defense against the South Africa team. She gets a yellow card for the tripping right on the line. 72-26 minutes into this game. And now is where the real action takes place. Caluso Biani kicks it in, hits the goalkeeper, but knocks off her hand, slips in, and that is a goal for the Republic of South Africa. Watch it again. Goalkeeper Hannah Siebert able to get her hands on it. It looks like it goes off of the leg of Rachel Sabati of South Africa, but it's Biani who kicked it in who actually gets credit for this first goal. In the dying minutes now, it's Kavita Batten who attempts a shot, but this one again will just be a bit too far to the right. USA still not on the board. Now in the added time, the referee calls it, and that is a quarterfinal victory for South Africa over Team USA. 1-0 after Caluso Biani's one goal. They will go on to play Japan tomorrow. Finally, we'll head to a jam-packed Taipei arena where men's basketball took place between the host city of Taipei and the Republic of Korea. Taipei sits in the fourth position as they take on the sixth position, Republic of Korea. Out of bounds off the tip gives Taipei the first possession. Chen Ying Chung gets one of his game-high 11 assists with a pass and bucket by Chen Kwon Chung. And Taipei takes the lead for the first time this game. Korea's Moon Seong-gong hits a three from the corner as they battle back to take the lead from Taipei. Then, with less than 10 seconds left to go in the first quarter, it's Su Yi Chen who gets around the defender in the key to take the lead by one to end the first. Now in the second, Korea starts this quarter with a three ball by Byung Jung-gung, which brings Korea now up by two. Then with Korea in the lead, Chang's spin move around the defender gets Taipei back within one. The lead would change 11 times throughout this game, but with Korea up one now, a jump shot by Kim Nak-young builds on that lead with less than a minute left to go in the first. Chen with another assist, Lee Kayang ties it up with a deep three ball with 21 seconds left to go. Third quarter now, 55-50. Chen pulls down the board and goes coast to coast. He dishes off to Hyung Tian Han in the corner, who bangs it in, and they take the biggest lead of the game so far. Now sitting at a 10-point lead, it's Korea who works the ball inside, and Park Jung-young puts up an easy 2 points. Then halfway through the fourth, Korea up by one. Chen drives through the key off the glass, left-handed. They take the lead now 72-71. Korea's Moon gets the inbound and goes coast to coast. No one there to stop him. He brings Korea now within four with 43 seconds left to go. Chen denied on the inbound. Taipei moves the ball up. Tight defense by Korea. Still able to get it up to Chang up top. Chen hanging out up top now, wasting some time because they do have that 2-point lead. Now 10 seconds on the shot clock. Everyone in the stadium counting down for him. He hands it off now and gets off the jumper to Fan Shiyang for the 15-foot. Check that out. Gives them a 4-point lead now with 12 seconds left to go. Shot clock is off. Korea down by four. Jiang Hyung-woo puts it up. Rebounded by Chang, and that will be the game. Taipei wins over the Republic of Korea 80-76. Chen scored a game-high 26 points, 10 assists, and pulled down 7 boards.